yellow, red, smoky eye shadow before. I had so much fun filming this tutorial. It's just so different. And I didn't want to, like, I wanted to do a different lower lash line for today's look. I did do a my bottom lip is fine, and this is my top lip. But I find, like, when the weather changes, or stress, or I think I'm just, like, over dry, it's usually my bottom lip is dry, but the top one is so swollen. I don't know. I can't really talk. Like, I showed my boyfriend. He was like, oh my god. Like, he's like, he tells me all the time, like, I have really nice lips and big lips. But he's like, your lips look huge. I was like, they feel huge. They feel swollen. Like, ugh. I don't know. Probably, like, allergic reaction. Also, I think I'm super dry. Maybe dehydrated. I was reading online. A lot of people told me that it's a sign of dehydration. But I drink water all day long. Like, I drink a lot of milk, too. But I drink a lot of water. That's why I go pee, like, 100 times a day. I'm telling you. People always tell me, like, I drink so much water, you know. And it's just, I'm always, like, thirsty all the time. Also, I go to the gym a lot. Water's good for you, to be honest. And my boyfriend drinks a lot of water. Like, when we go to McDonald's, he won't buy pop. He only drinks water, which is fine. I'm, like, a pop drinker, but he won't let me order pop. He's like, no, we're having water. Like, and honestly, water is the best. There's nothing better than water. Like, you cannot survive without water. But it's probably, my face isn't dry. It's just my fucking lips. A little bit on my nose, but that's okay. I think I'm going to do a mask. I might put the mask over my lip a little bit, but yeah. I actually loved how this eye makeup tutorial looked. This eye makeup looked. I applied some glitter. I was going to use the Stila one, but it was dried out. So I used the Pixie one in Sunray. It's actually a really, it's very similar, so I'm okay. The only thing I don't like about the Stila, where are you? I have the silver one. I might do the silver one for tomorrow's tutorial. What is this called? They're called the Glitter and Glow Liquid Eyeshadow. This one isn't dried out, but I have the gold one. It is dried out. And I went on to Sephora to buy another one, but they don't have the gold one for some reason. They only have, like, this one, and then they have, like, a rose gold one and a bronzy one, so I couldn't rebuy it. So actually the Pixie one is very similar. It's definitely a dupe for it. So those of you guys don't want to spend for the Stila one, this is a dupe for it. But I definitely want to use this silver one for tomorrow's tutorial because it's so beautiful. And this one's still not dried out because I think I just bought this, like, not that long ago, but whatever. Yeah, that's it for this tutorial. I hope you guys enjoy. I'm trying not to do my intros too long because some of my intros are so long. Like, they're like 10 minutes long. And I'm like, bitch, why are you talking so much? But I can't really talk right now because my lips are so swollen. Yeah, so I hope you enjoyed this video, you guys. I had so much fun filming, as always. Yeah, if you guys do this look, don't forget to tag me, add me, whatever. I love seeing when you guys do looks on my channel here that I inspire you. You guys inspire me back. I love it that we're a community here. And I had so much fun doing this tutorial for you guys. So if you guys want to see how I did this makeup look, just keep on watching. I love you guys so much. Bye. Hey, you guys, welcome back to my channel. I'm so excited to do this gold glitter red halo smoky eye. I'm gonna do like a pretty deep red smoky eye, and I'm wearing red, but I'm so sweaty. Like, it's 6 o'clock here in Vancouver, and like, it's like, I think it's like almost 25 degrees. It's so hot, and I'm doing laundry, which isn't a good idea. I'm just gonna start off with this video. My lips are so swollen and dry. My boyfriend told me to put ice, but it's still like so cracked and dry. It literally looks like I have lip injections, which you guys know. I admitted here on my channel that I don't do lip fillers, but I'm just gonna use this Kapari Lip Glossy because this has been helping on my lips. And when I applied my lipstick yesterday, my lips are so like plumped. Because a couple people mentioned, like, oh, did you get lip fillers? And I'm like, no. Okay, so I just applied foundation, concealer, under eye powder, face powder, and my eyebrows, which I did a pretty good job, but I'm just gonna like basically melt everything into the face. I'm just gonna use this Morphe continuous setting mist. This is how I've been doing my makeup recently, and I love how it makes my skin look. It makes my makeup like look like skin, and I love when my makeup's that cakey. There's like one on the bottom of the face also. Like, I'm super dry, and if you guys are super dry, always, before I apply my foundation, I always apply like any setting spray. You can even apply the Morphe one, but before I apply my actual foundation, I apply a Dewy setting mist, and then I love doing this to like hydrate everything because I'm so fucking dry. Yeah, especially when the weather changes. Oh, mama needs a timeout. Okay, so for today's look, we're going to move on to eyeshadow. I wanted actually to use a different palette for today. I'm going to use this bad boy. This is the Jeffree Star Cosmetics Androgyny palette. I had to ask my gay friend. I asked him, what does androgyny mean? He's like, basically, it doesn't mean like man or woman, which is what Jeffree is, which I love, like his whole vibe. I love all his makeup products. I love like his whole style. Like, it works for him. And I just love him and all his brushes, his channel. Like, he's so original, and I love him. And he's honest. Like, I love that he tells the truth. There's, like, no bullshit. And he's a, like, amazing business person. So I love this palette. At first, when this came out, like, a few years ago, at first when this palette came out, I wasn't like, oh, yeah, I have to have it. But I was like, there's some nice colors. But I've played with this before. I actually love this palette. It's, like, one of my favorites. I love the pans are really big. Like, I haven't even hit pan. Yeah, I love that the actual eyeshadows are really big. They're really pigmented. And I love that there's this big-ass mirror. Like, I love this palette. It's a really nice palette and has really great pigment. Okay, so I'm going to go in with a safe word. It's like kind of, it's actually like a really perfect transition color. Okay, and I'm going to go in with the Morphe R37, this really big fluffy brush. Like, look at that pigment. That's good. There's some kickback in it, but that's normal. You guys know. So we're just going to apply this all in the crease. This actually has like a really nice color to it. It's like not too dark, not too brown. It's like the perfect transition color. So So we're just going to apply this all in the crease. Basically want this color to be the first color in the eye look. This look to be super blown out today. Okay, moving on, we're just going to apply some translucent loose setting powder. So this is the Fenty Beauty Pro Filt'r Instant Retouch Setting Powder in the shade Lavender. You guys know I love this because it has a really nice brightening effect because I'm so pale. Oops, I think I like laughed and I kind of blew everywhere. Oh, wow. Okay, further than that. Yeah, I couldn't sleep yesterday, so I woke up really late, which is why I'm filming now. I don't know, I've been like kind of not in a really good mood lately. I don't know, it's the weather. Like, I feel kind of tired and like hot. I was going to go to the store today, but when I go to the store, I don't like to go later in the afternoon because it gets so hot and then I feel like fainting. So I usually like to go earlier in the day and then I can go home and do whatever kind of thing. Yeah. Okay, now I'm just going to use this one. This color is called Charm. It's this really pretty orangey color and it has sparkles in it. It's actually really pretty. I'm just going to use the same brush because why not? We're just going to tap that off and I'm just going to put this right under that safe word color. I just want to warm up with that crease. Like that. And this has like really great pigments. I love Jeffree's eyeshadow palettes because they're so pigmented. Like, they're just bomb products. Okay, now going in with some darker colors, I'm going to use the M433 and I'm going to use this Fetish color. So it's like this really deep red with shimmer in it. It kind of reminds me, MAC used to have this red color, the single eyeshadow, but they don't anymore. It kind of reminds me of the same color, but it looks really pretty and this is my vibe and I want to do this color. Like, look at that pigment. That is red. Okay, we're just gonna pat this right in the outer corner of the lid. And this red has great pigments, especially like for a really like red shade like this one. It's really hard to develop because like I find a lot of red colors, they have like a little bit brown in it. This one is just like pure red with some shimmer in it. It's really pretty. And just blending it with that orange shade, it's like coming together. And my main focus is the outer corner because this is a halo look. Okay, now we're going to do the inner corner, but I'm going to use a different brush. I'm going to use this one. This is the Morphe 431, and because I have such small eyes, I like a really small, like, taper guy. We're just going to go back in with that Fetish color, tap it off. We don't want a lot of fallout, and just, like, kind of get that inner corner, meeting with that outer corner. And I always like to drag it, like, more in the middle. And then we're just using that R37 with no extra product with that orangey shade. We're just going to like blend any harsh lines there. whenever you need, you can add more of that orangey color to blend out that red fetish color. Yeah. Such a pretty color, you guys. It's so pigmented and it's so easy to blend. Kidding me? Okay, we're gonna do the other eye. Okay, I know it's kind of like in your face, but I'm in it. Okay, now using that M433 brush, and we're just gonna deepen it a little bit. We're gonna use this color, Dominatrix. Love that name. It's like this really deep chocolatey brown color. I'm just gonna use the same 433 brush. Just gonna tap a little because these colors are so pigmented. Just gonna deepen the crease a little bit. So this is a smoky eye. Just like that, because I don't want this smoky eye to be too red. I'm gonna add some brown in there. Okay, and then we're gonna use that little guy. This is the 431. We're just gonna dip in Dominatrix just to connect the inner corner. Ugh, my nose is so itchy. Oh my god, this Dominatrix color with this fetish color is so beautiful. It's just really rich. We're just gonna grab some Charm. Oh my nose, there's so much powder in my nose. And grab the R37. And we're just gonna blend those colors together. Because I don't want no harsh lines. Want everything to look blended, especially with like darker smoky shades. I find it's more noticeable, so that's why I always take my time to blend everything out, if that makes sense. Yeah. Okay, we're gonna do the same thing for the other eye now. Yeah, it's coming together. I know this look kind of looks high, but I'm kind of in it. Just saying. Okay, moving on. I'm going to go in with this gold color. It's called a frosting. It's actually really pretty. Show you. Like, it's a really nice gold. Kind of in it right now. And I'm going to use the MAC 242 brush. I love using this brush for packing on glitter, any glitter, to be honest with you. I'm just going to spray the brush with some setting spray. I don't know if you guys do this. Like, I like can't remember when I never sprayed my brush. Now I always do it. Like, I have to do it. It's like a makeup artist trick. Like, it just makes the glitter look so metallic. And I'm kind of into that look. So we're just going to place this in the center of the eye. Like that. I know it looks messy right now, but we're gonna blend it out. I'm just gonna do the other eye really quickly. And grabbing that fetish and Dominatrix color just to blend the inner corner. I always do this. Like, look, like this side's looking so much better than this side because it's like kind of like brown, gold, and then just like it just doesn't blend. It just looks choppy and I don't like it. Just going over top of that gold color. Yeah, that's better. Just using the R37 with more of that Charm color, that orangey color, and just blending it out. Yeah. Okay, and then we're gonna grab the the MAC 242 brush. We're just gonna grab that frosting color a little bit because when we blended that gold color, it kind of covered it up, and I don't want it all covered up. I always do this guy, this step, you guys. I always, like, go back and forth. I know it's a little bit, like, high maintenance, but this is, like, how I get my makeup to look so, so perfect. So we're just gonna dab right in the center there. Perfect! See, so much, like, this eye looks so much better than this eye. Like, this eye looks blended. This is just choppy. And then we're going to do the same thing on the other eye. And forth a little bit. Yeah, that's better because we're going to add some glitter. Okay, moving on. I think I'm going to move on to the lower lash line now. I'm just going to remove that bakage off. Well, it is May, so I shouldn't be asking that. Okay, moving on to the lower lash line. I think I want to play with some greens and blues because I don't want to make this color, like, overly red or anything. I'm loving this, like, kind of yellowy green color. This is in the shade Military. It's such a beautiful, light green color. I'm loving it. Okay, what brush do I want to use? I'm going to go in with the Elite Collection from Morphe. This is the E18. I love this brush. It's one of my go-tos for my lower lash line. And we're just going to apply this all over. Because we're doing a smoky eye, I want it to be really blown out. Now, I'm just going to grab, where are you? I'm going to grab this definer guy. This is the Morphe M423. I think I'm going to grab this one. This is in the color Poison. I don't want to do blue. Yeah, it's kind of like a teal kind of color, and I'm feeling this teal color. I'm just going to put that all in the lower lash line. This color has really nice pigment. Yeah, I'm living. Perfect. Okay, and then which brush am I going to grab? I'm going to grab the Morphe R41. I don't want this to be too dark, so I'm just going to grab that Military color again, and I'm just going to buff that Poison color. So I don't want this to be, like, overpowering the red. You know? Actually really pretty. I'm living. Okay, and then to make that really, really smoky, I'm just going to grab that Kylie brush again, and we're just going to go in with Military. Just because. I just want this to be so blown out. You're like, damn, girl. See, that's so much better. See? Perfect. Okay, I'm just going to apply some more translucent setting powder just to perfect that lower lash line a little bit. I always do this step. Just kind of cut it there. And I love it. I love how pigmented these are. And it's like a retractable pencil. It's really cool. You just twist it up. And it's so pigmented. like, especially for a bright teal color, like, that's shocking. Because I find with a lot of brighter eye pencils, they're not super pigmented. So we're just going to put this in the waterline. Although I can't really see, so. Oh, yeah, it's showing up. Oh, that's pigmented. Sorry, it's hard to see in the camera. It's not the same as a mirror. There, that's better. It's just like so green and teal, and I'm in it. I love this pencil. It's one of my favorites. Okay, now we're just gonna I'm just gonna clean up my eyebrows really quickly with some concealer, just because your eyes pop. Okay, I'm just gonna use I've been loving this Makeup Forever Starlit powder in the shade 13. This is in the shade Ivory. I've been loving highlighting my brow bone with this just because it's so finely milled and it's so intense, especially when you add setting spray to it. This is my journey. I'm just saying. This is my vibe. I'm just going to apply this on the brow bone really quickly. Yeah, it's just so white and kind of like intense. I'm in it. Okay, now for the inner corner, I'm going to use this Dior Backstage Glow Face Palette. So this is in the shade 001 Universal. I've been loving using this gold color and this white color. So I'm going to go in with strobe gold, and then I'm going to go in with white strobe white. And what brush do I want to use? I'm just going to use this bullet guide. This is the M455. So I'm just going to dip. I just love these powders so much, especially like doing the inner corner. I love it. This is my vibe. Especially since we did like a gold look, this is just gonna make it pop. Okay, and then we're going in with strobe white just to make it even more intense. I don't want my inner corner to be too gold. I find if you do like too much of a gold brow highlight or too much of a gold inner corner, it's not as flattering as like more of a champagne kind of white. Okay, now I'm going to highlight the under eye really quickly, and I'm going to use the Charlotte Tilbury Airbrush Flawless Finish Skin Perfecting Micro Powder in the shade One Fair. Such a long name for a face powder, but I've been loving this powder lately. It's such a beautiful powder, and when you apply it, it goes on like so smooth. So I'm just going to use my beauty sponge, the tip part. I'm just going to tap under the eye. Really lightly. It's just in the shade Flare. I've used this on my channel before, and you guys know I love it. But I just want to use this first just to make it really like, I don't know. I find like when you just put like a glitter liquid shadow, it's kind of choppy. But I find when you do like an actual like metallic eyeshadow and you put it underneath, it just makes it more pigmented and it just shows more. Just my opinion. Okay, we're just going to apply this right in the center where we applied that gold color in the center.
like that.
Like that, that's perfect. It's like honestly enough. Okay. Like that. And then we're going to use the Pixie by Petra. This is the liquid fairy lights in the shade Sunray. It's really pretty. You see, this by itself is a little choppy, but when we apply it over that flare color, I'll show you. It's just intense. Like, it just makes such a big difference. Yeah, we're just going to apply this really lightly just into the center. Oh, that's so fucking beautiful. That's gold. And then sometimes I'll use like a flat synthetic brush just to like pat it out a little bit. Because you want it like blended. But I have to say this Sunray color is very similar to the Stila one. So we're not missing out. I love the Stila one, but it just dries out. That's what I don't like about it. It's not that I have to be like perfect with my makeup today because I'm not going anywhere, but just saying. Okay, that seems good. Now we're just gonna apply a mascara. And I'm gonna go in with the L'Oreal Paris Voluminous Lash Paradise. I'm just gonna coat the lashes really lightly. Now I'm gonna use the Flutter Double Lift Intoxicating Lashes. These are my favorite lashes, and to be honest, I think it's gonna be so freaking pretty with this eye look. I'm just gonna test it out and see how I like it. Bitch, I'm obsessed. I'm honestly obsessed. It's so beautiful. Okay, I'm just a little thirsty. I'm so sweaty, you guys. It's so hot today. Like that. Perfect. Okay, we're gonna move on to contour. I'm just gonna put this away. My lips are still so freaking dry. Okay, for contour, I'm just gonna use this one because I've been loving this contour palette. And this is the Dior Backstage contour palette. I love these two contour shades. It's such a beautiful, warm contour. Haven't even touched my Kat Von D one. But I'm gonna go in with contour light and contour deep because this one's too light and this one's too dark. So I always like to mix them. And then I'm gonna go in with the Morphe times Jaclyn Hill brush. This is the JH05. Honest, you guys, this is my go-to contour. It's so freaking beautiful. It has such a nice finish to it. So beautiful. I like a really light contour, not too dark. I'm just not, like, I find a lot of men, they love running outside. That's not my thing. I've never loved running outside. I'm more like a treadmill girl. That's who I am. Just saying. Okay, that's looking pretty good. I'm gonna move on with bronzer. I think for this makeup tutorial, I want to do like kind of a golden bronze. So I'm gonna use this Morphe one. I've been loving this Morphe bronzer. It's just such a beautiful bronze golden color, but it's not too dark, so I've been loving it. So this is a Morphe Glamour Bronze Face and Body Bronzer. This is their old packaging. It comes in a black packaging, and it doesn't have like these kind of ingrays. It's just like flat, but it's such a beautiful bronze color. It's really golden. Like, it's so pretty, and it's gonna be freaking beautiful with this look. It's just saying. I hope it cools down because I'm so sweaty, you guys. It's like crazy. And I really love using this bronzer as eyeshadow too. Okay, we're just gonna apply this all in the cheeks. And since we did such a warm kind of golden red smoky eye, and that darker brown we used has a little redder red warm undertones, so I want to use like a really kind of golden warm bronzer, especially because that Dior contour palette is a really warm contour color. It's not really cool tone. So I want to use kind of like a golden undertone of bronzer. I'm just going to warm up the face. And it's going to be perfect with my skin tone right now because I'm so freaking pale, to be honest. Perfect. Okay. I know I look crazy, but whatever. Okay, and now while that bakeage is sitting on the face, I'm just gonna use that Morphe Icon bronzer using this Kylie Slanted Goat Hair brush. This is my favorite brush for contouring my nose, but I like contouring my nose with bronzer because it's like more of a, because I have such a freaking high bridge. Like, my nose has nothing on right now. Like, look at my nose. Like, it looks fake. So I like to do more of a lighter contour because I find if I apply actual contour powder, my nose looks fake. Just saying. So really lightly. And I always like to start from the eyebrow because that's where your nose starts. Just saying. And this is like more of a lighter bronzer. So this bronzer is actually perfect for my nose contour. We're not done with that. And then we're just going to remove the bakeage off. It doesn't matter what you do. That's just how it is, honey. Okay. Let's put that into the skin. Okay, that's good. And then we're just going to use that Charlotte Tilbury in One Fair. And we're just going to apply this all on the bottom of the face. Love a highlighted chin area. Jawline? Jawline. Especially because we highlighted the under eye. It just like ties the whole face together. It looks like it told me. My boyfriend told me that it's going to be a while before you get anything. I ordered extensions for my friend to do. I bought them off Wish. They were like $30 because one of his friends told them that she bought it off Wish. And it's the same hair that I bought from Montreal that he got from this supplier. And I think it should be in the mail soon. So hopefully I'll message him and he can do my hair. Because some came out, but my hair still looks pretty good. Anyways, for blush, I think I want to do like a warm coppery blush because we did a really warm eye look for today's look. So I think I want to go in with Copper Tone and Modern Mandarin. I love these two shades together. They're like one of my faves. Okay, I'm going to use this Jaclyn Hill Morphe brush. This is the JH06. I love this brush because it's really fluffy and it's not going to be too harsh. Yeah, I love these. They're like one of my favorite shades to use together. Like, it's so like warm and coral, and it's kind of like gives you like a bronzy kind of cheek. Looks really beautiful together. in my makeup routine, I'm going to use the Hourglass Ambient Lighting Powder in the shade Luminous Light. I love this powder. It's so beautiful. And if you feel like you put too much blush on, this is the part that will diffuse the blush. So we're just going to use the Morphe M500 really lightly. Oh, it's such a beautiful powder. Just gives you that extra glow, like the glow from within the actual highlight. Applying this is so refreshing because it's so hot right now. I'm just going to use the fan because I'm sweating my balls over here. Sweaty balls I have. Just kidding. I'm going to use a different, it's just over here. I'm going to go in with the Anastasia Beverly Hills Nicole Guerrero Glow Kiss. I love her. This is like such a great thing, like Anastasia Beverly Hills. She's such a big brand, and for a YouTuber to collaborate with them is such a, like, it's so amazing. I love that. Yeah, they just bought this back at Sephora, so I know for a fact they still have it. I bought this like 2 years ago, 3 years ago. I've used it before, but I don't use it all the time, but I love this palette. Like in the actual pan, it looks super sparkly, but they're not sparkly when you swatch it. Which one do I want to use? I'll show you. They're like really like wet looking. I'll just swatch them all. Yeah, see, they're not glittery at all. To be honest, they're kind of like more of a shimmer glow, which is kind of nice. Yeah, they're actually really nice. Yeah, Anastasia just bought this back into her onto Sephora, which I thought was like pretty awesome, because those of you, like, when Anastasia comes out with like a palette or anything, you can never get it. But I bought it right away because I'm that bitch. I'll be like online in cart. But she bought it back. She does that with a few other things, like Amarisi. She has a gold highlight. She bought that back because I don't think a lot of people could buy it, so they bought it back. So you guys can definitely buy this palette if you guys see or like this palette. I definitely recommend. It has great pigment. It does have fallout, but usually Anastasia highlights, because they're so kind of glittery, they usually do have fallout. But it's a great palette. I think I want to use, because we did more of a gold kind of warm smoky eye, I think I want to go more with a gold color. So I'm going to go in with Glow Getter. Ooh, girl. And I'm just going to use this Morphe times Jeffree Star JS4 highlighting brush. This is my go-to highlighting brush I've been using. I've been loving her. So I'm just going to tap that out. I'm just going to place this on the cheeks. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. It's, like, so highlighted and wet looking. I'm in it. It's actually really pretty. Yeah, I forgot how much I love Anastasia highlights. And I think that she did some eyeshadows, like the eyeshadows she started getting famous for, and a lot of people like those. And then she started doing highlight kits, and then obviously she's super famous for her eyebrows. But I don't love everything of hers, but majority of what I buy from Anastasia is really good. Yeah, that's like so wet. Okay, I want to use another highlight because I'm just that bitch. I think I'm going to go in with Forever Lit because I just want to add some light and whiteness. And I'm just going to use my beauty sponge. I've been loving using my beauty sponge applying highlight. I always do this with the second color because it just kind of pops. I'm in it. I'm with it. And we're just going to tap really lightly. Oh yeah, that's intense. It's a little much, but whatever. I'm kind of in it. because it's a little too white, I'm just going to add another highlight because I'm that bitch. I'm just going to go in with the Becca Cosmetics Shimmering Skin Perfector Press Highlighter in Champagne Pop because this has really nice peachy undertones. And because we did a glittery gold eye, I think it's just going to complement with this eye look because this is looking too white for me. Just saying. I'm just gonna lightly apply to the high points of the cheek. Yeah. Just like that. Yeah, that just makes it so much more intense. You know me. I'm an intense bitch. Okay, for a lip liner. Where is she? Where is she? Okay, here she is. I want to use I have so many pencils. I want to use Huda Beauty Lip Contour in the shade Wifey. So I love this color because we want to do more of a nude for today's look. Because with any like red smoky eye or like a smoky eye, I like to do more of a nude lip color because it just like complements better. And I don't like to do a super smoky eye with a crazy dark lip color. I think you look like a whore, to be honest. Not a whore, like a hooker. No, I'm just kidding, you guys. It's not flattering is what I'm trying to say. Okay, we're just going to apply this all over the lips. Okay, I want to use a different lip color for today's look. I'm going to use this Marc Jacobs one. I haven't used this on my channel before. So this is the liquid lip cream. I think I'm going to use this because my lips are so dry. So it's like a hydrating lip color. So it's like shiny and it's like a lip color all in one. So it's going to be perfect for today's look because my lips are dry and chapped. I love the color because it's such a pretty peachy color. I have another color in this, but it's kind of like an orangey undertone. Which one is it? This one. It's called Yours to Try. It's a little too like pale. I don't know. It's too orangey for my skin. Yeah, see, I like this one because it's more peachy. Just my opinion. This is what I'm using. Now my thing is stuck in on. Oh my god. It's super hydrating though, I have to say that. It's such a pretty color though, I love it. I'm in it. I have a cut here, so I just want to cover that. Yeah, I'm in it. It's super hydrating and I love the color. It's pretty. It's a little more on the peachy side, but that's okay. I'm just going to spray more of that continuous setting mist. Then I just squirt some on my face. Just something different, you know? Okay, I'm just going to apply some clear brow gel really quickly. Okay, Now, I'm just going to apply a lower lash mascara. I'm going to use the MAC Extended Play Giga Black Lash. This is my favorite lower lash mascara because the wand is so freaking skinny. Only skinny thing I like. Ha, get it? That's not what she said. Just kidding. Okay. It's looking, I'm looking real cute. I think that's good. I'm just gonna curl my hair really quickly. I'll be right back, you guys. I gotta wash it like tonight. Yeah, just ignore my upper lip because it's really cracked and swollen. I do have a cut here, so I basically just grabbed some lip liner and just like covered it up. They look so fucking swollen, and my bottom lip, I don't know, like it hurts, but hopefully it'll get better soon. I tried, my boyfriend told me to apply ice. That helped a little bit, but they're still really like swollen and sore and hurt. Like, ugh, like I don't know, they look enormous. I don't know if that's a bad thing, but oh well. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. I know I wasn't talking too much in the video. I don't know, I feel a little bit tired today. I think it's like I woke up at 1. I definitely have to start going to bed early because, I don't know, this whole sleep regimen is not good. And I find I have a really hard time staying asleep. Like, I'll wake up at 9 and then I can't go back to sleep. And then, I don't know, I need a normal sleeping schedule. I think because I'm not going to the gym regularly, it's kind of like fucking with my sleep. Because I mainly go for, I go to the gym for like mood. Like, it just improves my mood so much. And I also go to the gym, like, if I feel stressed, it's basically a release that I feel. And it just, I don't know, I feel, and for sleep, obviously you sleep better when you go to the gym. That's just my thing. And I usually go in the morning before work. That's my thing. I definitely really miss going to the gym. That's like my thing. I don't know, working out at home, I still do workouts at home. It's not the same. I'll go for a walk, but it's been so hot lately. I get like really lightheaded. I don't think I'm drinking enough water. I don't know. It's not healthy. It's not good. But I hope you guys really enjoy this video. I had a lot of fun creating this look. I love this lip color. And I love the fact that you don't have to apply a lip gloss because it's a shiny liquid lip. And I actually really liked it. And I love this color. It's like a really pretty peachy color. The only thing I don't like is because my lips are cracked. You can kind of see. Kind of look like Angelina Jolie. I feel like I can't move my mouth, but whatever. That's probably the weather. It is definitely warmer. And I find whenever it's warm, my skin is just, oh. Anyways, you guys, I actually love this eye makeup look. I loved using this Androgyny palette. I believe he still has this palette. It's definitely, I do my approval on this one. It's a great palette. I love it. It's so beautiful. I love the packaging. I love the colors, the pigmentation. It does have a little bit kickback. I have to say, like, this orangey color definitely has more kickback than the others, but that's nothing that bothers me really. I know a lot of people that don't like that. They're like, I find women are so picky, women and men, women, like, we're so picky when it comes to makeup. If something like doesn't like blend properly or there's a bunch of kickback, people complain. And you know what, like, I always like to give a product or a brand a chance, but if I try and it's not good, then I'm like, okay. But yeah, this is a great palette, great pigmentation. I actually really love this color. Maybe I'll use that in a video. But it's a really pretty color. Loved all this color. And I love that I didn't do a red lower lash line. I kind of played with, sorry, my nose is so itchy. I'm like, it's a bad day for me. I love that I use that yellowy green color with that blue color. So beautiful. And you guys know I love this MARC Jacobs eyeliner. So great. I love his eyeliners. They're so pigmented. And I love his packaging. I just love everything MARC Jacobs. And this lip combination, I'm in it. I'm in it. I wear this on an everyday basis. And I wanted to use the Stila Glow Liquid Glitter for you guys. Where are you? But it was dried out in the gold one. But this is the Diamond Dust one. This one's still good. So I might use that in tomorrow's tutorial, I might do like an easy glitter glam makeup tutorial. I love just applying this on its own and it's all good. And then doing like a red lip or a nude lip. I might do this tomorrow with a nude lip, but I love this. I haven't used the Stila one on my channel, so I might do that for tomorrow, which I'm super excited for. Yeah, love this palette, love the name, love the packaging. Definitely approve of that, and I love that I use a different highlight today. I use this one, the Nicole Hierro. I love this palette. They just, I believe this is on her website still. She has a lot of the older highlights on her website still, but on Sephora, they only have limited stuff. Like, Sephora, they definitely brought this back, so if you guys do like it and you don't have it, you definitely can go get it. Go get it now. It's a great palette, great colors in it. It does look a little glittery, like there is like a lot of fallout. It looks glittery in the pan, but it's really not. It's a really nice, pretty, smooth highlight, and I love the color. Like, really like this one. But I love this gold highlight and this white together. It's just so beaming, so beautiful. I love it. It was bomb. Yeah. I loved everything I did in this tutorial. I love this look. It's very like glam. And I love doing little smoky eyes for you guys. You guys love it. So yeah, that's it for this chit chat video. I'm trying to keep my intros and outros a little bit shorter because I don't know. Some of my outros are like 10 minutes long and I'll be editing. I'm like, why am I talking so much? But anyways, you guys, I hope you really enjoyed this video. Yeah, give it a thumbs up, subscribe to my channel. I love you guys so much, and thank you all for watching my tutorials, commenting. I love you guys so much. And yeah, if you guys do this, look, just tag me. I love it when you guys tag me, add me on Facebook, whatever. I love interacting with my YouTubers, and I love doing makeup, and I love that you guys love makeup as much as I do. So you should see my collection. I'm obsessed. It's my hobby. Yeah, so any other looks you guys want to see on my channel, let me know. I have a few looks in mind that you guys mentioned to me, but I'm going to do a really simple glitter glam tomorrow. I've been doing like super intense makeup looks. I just want to do something fresh, something simple, something fun. Anyways, guys, have an amazing day, and don't forget to like, and I hope you guys, yeah, love this video as much as you can. Bye! God.